Hello, I'm Charles Haskell. This is my fifth video talk about UUSM history from my 40-year membership perspective. First, I'll talk about the Westside Coalition for Housing, Hunger, and Health, and then I'll say a few words about Kathy Gentile. After the first annual issues election in January of 2001, when the congregation overwhelmingly voted for hunger and homelessness to be our number one priority for our first new programs, we looked around for a potential partner that we could work with on these issues. We knew from experience that we were not capable of doing it entirely by ourselves. We were very happy to discover the Westside Shelter and Hunger Coalition, which has subsequently been renamed the Westside Coalition for Housing, Hunger, and Health. The Westside Coalition was founded in 1982 and is the longest running nonprofit of its type in the United States. The organization coordinates service involving nonprofit organizations, governmental organizations, and faith-based organizations. The important major organizations within the coalition that I should mention include, first, the Westside Food Bank. Bruce Rankin has been directing that for more than 20 years, and it's a major source of food in our community. Secondly, OPCC, the Ocean Park Community Center, was the original name. It was subsequently just changed to the acronym OPCC, and more recently has been expanded to include more of Los Angeles under the name The People Concern. It's directed by John Masseri and has very important constituents that are in Santa Monica. The Swashlock, in particular, is a place where homeless people can take a shower, have a cot, and put their stuff in a locker for some period of time while they look for transitional housing. There is transitional housing with Turning Point. There's also an important battered women's shelter as part of OPCC, and we have partnered with them ever since that time. Step Up on Second is an important housing resource for the mentally ill. Upward Bound House provides transitional housing for people who are pulling their lives together, and they provide educational experiences and parenting classes for families that are in transition. Others include the Venice Family Clinic, St. Joseph Center, which, by the way, is where our former minister, the Reverend Rebecca Benefield Bijoux, is currently working, continuing her work in social justice. The VA is involved with its New Directions program, and we are a member faith-based organizations, including other churches and synagogues in the area. This provides an overview of the group. I must say that the major activity that we observe in the community is actually two things. One, they have an annual fundraiser, a bowl-a-thon. The other is an annual breakfast at a local hotel in the fall. This is called the Success Breakfast, and the constituent organizations in the Westside Coalition can nominate one or two people, and generally between 20 and 25 people are identified as having gone from being homeless to having a job and a home helped by one of the or more of the organizations in the coalition. This breakfast is one that we've attended for many years. This shows the UUSM table that we had for the 17th annual breakfast. And at that time, we enjoyed seeing pictures of the individual honorees and hearing their and reading their stories. The portraits in this book were taken by me and I've been privileged to be the portrait photographer for the coalition since 2003. In subsequent videos, I'll tell more about how we have interacted with individual member organizations of the coalition. I'd like to close with some comments about Kathy Gentile. In my fourth video, I incorrectly said that the Faith in Action Commission chairs were first Ken Marie Mitchell, and secondly me, and then third Rick Rhodes. That was incorrect. Kathy Gentile succeeded me with as chair of the commission for two terms and did a terrific job. She's continued after that as a co-chair of the Peace Committee and has been involved with economic justice issues. And I think it's fair to say that she has a distinguished involvement in social justice issues for over 20 years in our church, and she's an inspiration to us all. That concludes my overview of the Westside Coalition, and as said before, I will have subsequent videos discussing in more detail how we've interacted with individual groups.